Now that you've played a little bit defining your own rasters, one of the things that pops up thinking about the scale question, thinking about the definition question is, well, why don't we just use 1 meter pixels for everything? Probably solve some problems in terms of making decisions. If your pixels are smaller, you can more accurately represent the landscape. If your pixels are smaller, then you have more flexibility in terms of what you can show and what you can see. But if your pixels are smaller, you also have a lot more of them. And more pixels is great until you have to store them long term, until you have to send the files, until you have to process them, until you have to do a lot of work with those pixels. Increased file size. Because you're storing more data, you're storing more information, you are storing more digits, storing more binary or integer or float data, all of this stuff. The more you're storing and the more pixels you have, the bigger your file size. That eventually becomes a processing load that most computers can't handle. They can't do it. They are out of capacity, whether that's hard drive space or processing memory or what have you, it becomes too much. So we are dealing with pixels and resolution of different size and of different characteristics, not only because of storage requirements, processing requirements, sensors aren't that accurate. You get LiDAR data, laser or light detecting and ranging, laser maps. LiDAR data of elevation at 1 meter resolution. If you have that for the whole state of Massachusetts, you've got gigabytes of data to deal with. And that's not necessarily reasonable for everyone to have to deal with. So everything can't be 1 meters. You think Massachusetts is big, go out west, and suddenly you're looking at trillions of pixels. It's a lot of pixels. We've talked a little bit about these raster data advantages. A surface of data, every location has a value. It's continuous. So, what we mean by a continuous surface, everything has a value. Depending on what you're looking at, it can be smaller than a shapefile, depending on how things are structured. Not always, though. And of course, they look good, as long as you're not zoomed into their resolution. But maybe you like pixels. Maybe you like pixel art. Maybe you like the way that they look. All right, but as we know, raster data aren't perfect. Talked a little bit more about this when we were talking about vectors, because I was kind of down on rasters in that presentation. But what shapes a pixel? If I have a shape that is the same length on both sides, what shape do I have? That's right, a square. And the square piece goes in the square hole. Anyway, this is important because not every coordinate system is going to preserve that square. A square in one projection is not a square in another projection. We see this in Lab 6. So rasters are really should be locked to the coordinate system they are built in. Because otherwise they get tilty or stretched or squished or pulled or pushed. So raster data really has less manipulations in terms of projection than vector data. Plus, we also need to align our rasters. If we have many different rasters at many different resolutions, there's actually a lot of both thinking work and computational work in making sure that those rasters are lining up. Converting between different pixel sizes just means different translations or different recalculations, and none of that is good for us because it's changing the data once again. We're keeping our rasters all aligned. It's really tough. Finally, another really interesting, complicated piece of raster data is this idea of downscaling, where you take a large pixel and you turn it into smaller pixels, usually with other data or other information informing your work. This makes for a very interesting, very troublesome problem. If we have big pixels but want to understand the results of those over small areas, how do we actually turn that big pixel into something meaningful for a smaller part of the landscape? And that problem is called downscaling. So take a look at this really cool video from NCAR. NCAR is based in Boulder, Climate Analysis and Research. It's the national center for that. Yeah, that covers that acronym, I think. Check out this little video on downscaling. Links on Moodle. We'll talk a little bit more about how that comes into play when we're working with raster data.